In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. We gather this beautiful day to give thanks to the Lord for his presence among us. And to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins. Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offer you right and praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Romans. I myself am conceived about you, my brothers and sisters, that you yourselves are full of goodness, filled with all knowledge, and able to admonish one another. But I have written to you rather boldly in some respects to remind you, because of the grace given me by God to be a minister of Christ to the Gentiles in performing the priestly service of the gospel of God, so that offering up the Gentiles may be acceptable, sanctified by the Holy Spirit, in Christ Jesus. Then I have a reason to boast in what pertains to God. For I will not dare to speak of anything except what Christ has accomplished through me, to lead the Gentiles to obedience by word and deed, by the power and signs of wonders. By the power of the Spirit of God, so that from Jerusalem and all the way around to Illyricum, I have finished preaching the gospel of Christ. Thus I aspire to proclaim the gospel, not where Christ has already been named, so I do not build on another's foundation, but as it is written, those who have been told of him shall see, and those who have never heard of him shall understand. The word of the Lord. The response is, the Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. Sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wondrous deeds. His right hand has won victory for him, his holy arm. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. The Lord has made his salvation known. In the sight of the nations, he has revealed his justice. He has remembered his kindness and his faithfulness towards the house of Israel. The Lord has revealed to the nations his saving power. All the ends of the earth have seen the salvation by our God. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Break in song, sing praise. The Lord has revealed to his nations his saving power.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, a rich man had a steward who was reported to him for squandering his property. He summoned him and said, what is this I hear about you? Prepare a full account of your stewardship because you can no longer be my steward. The steward said to himself, what shall I do now that my master is taking the position of steward away from me? I'm not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. I know what I shall do so that when I am removed from the stewardship, they may welcome me into their homes. He called in his master's debtors one by one, To the first he said, "How much do you owe my master?" He replied, 100 measures of olive oil. He said to him, "Here is your promissory note. Sit down and quickly write one for 50. Then to another he said, "And you, how much do you owe?" He replied, 100 measures of wheat. He said to him, "Here is your promissory note. Write one for 80. And the master commended that dishonest steward for acting prudently. For the children of this world are more prudent in dealing with their own generation than the children of light. The Gospel of the Lord. What is 2 plus 2? 4. What if I told you 2 plus 2 is 5? Would that make it true? What if I told you, if you will agree that 2 plus 2 equals 5, I will buy you the latest iPhone? How many of you would do that? Oh, come on. Yeah, you would. You see, the world has different sort of rules and values than what Jesus preached. See, the world will tell you that it's okay to cheat on a homework assignment or a test as long as you don't get caught. It's not cheating. Or it's okay to drive over the speed limit as long as you don't get caught. Or it's okay to lie to someone as long as you don't get caught. The world has a different set of values. But our Lord valued truth. Just because I convince you to say 2 plus 2 equals 5 can never make that true. And just because you don't get caught doesn't mean something isn't wrong. It seems like in our gospel that our Lord is giving credit to this dishonest man. But he's just saying, this man is following the rules of the world, and he's going to do well in the world. But in the next world, he's not going to do so well, because there's different rules. Don't be fooled by the rules of the world. Embrace the rules of Christ. Embrace love and truth and forgiveness and justice and kindness. They'll get you through this world, and they'll get you to the next one. And now let us stand as we gather our prayers to our Heavenly Father. With confidence in God's love for us, we now present our needs.
The response is, "Lord, hear our prayer." For Pope Francis, bishops, priests, and all the clergy, that they will continue to guide us according to God's word, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For members of our Army, Navy, Marines, Coast Guard, and Air Force, that the Lord may preserve them and keep them from harm, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the nations of the world will seek to work together in harmony and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are suffering, that they will find comfort through peace and loved ones and prayer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially veterans who have given their lives for our country, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, we thank you for always listening to our prayers. We ask that you grant what is best for us through Christ our Lord. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation and for us a holy outpouring of your mercy, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Thomas our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Anthony, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven,
give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Our spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall. Thank you. Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise, through Christ our Lord. I'd like to thank everyone who helped with our liturgy today, especially our wonderful choir, our seventh graders and altar servers, our wonderful lectors. Thank you all. Have a wonderful weekend. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.